Astrophysics. Have you ever wanted to witness the birth of a star? Our universe is vast, and distance and size are huge barriers to observing many phenomena. Supercomputers allow us to simulate these phenomena and observe the currently unobservable.
We know that these stars form in clouds of fairly dense and very cold gas and dust. And we know that these clouds are turbulent, and we know that that turbulence will influence what types of stars are formed. When we are trying to understand this type of turbulence, we can't just go and do an experiment and try and study it like that. What we need to do is computer simulations. So we do the computer simulations, and then we try to link those with the observations, so link them with the things that we see in telescopes. And the main work that I'm doing is basically extending the physics that we've been able to include in these simulations of turbulence to more realistic physics. And of course, when you extend the physics, that means you've got a higher computational cost. So we need very high power supercomputers to deal with this issue. So the main thing that we've found is, through the inclusion of the extra physics that we've been able to do, is that the turbulence in these clouds in which stars are forming will form density structures only of certain sizes. And you may say, now, why is this relevant? This is relevant really because how stars form depend completely on the kinds of density structures that you form. So exactly where all the mass in the cloud is, and is it big lumps of mass or very small lumps of mass or whatever. So the kinds of star formation that occurs depends completely on that. And it turns out that the physics that we've been able to introduce into our simulations has a very significant impact on exactly that. So we know that this extra physics, which has never been done before, does actually have critical influence over star formation, which is one of the fundamental problems in astrophysics.